Hey guys, welcome back. Dreamweaver23 here, and today we're going to be going through the steps to get started programming your brand new Sphero robot. Now, the Sphero robots come in all different types. We have the new Sphero Bolt, we have the Sphero Mini, the BB-8, the BB-9E, the R2-D2, the R2-Q5, we have the Ollie, there's the Spark. There's so many different types of Spheros that are out there, but you can use the Sphero EDU programming site to actually program all of these Spheros, including the Star Wars Spheros. To get started, we're going to go over to edu.sphero.com. And that's going to bring you to this site right here. On that one, you can sign up. If you have not created an account, you can get sign up through there. You can also just go to sign in. You can also get the app through here, or I can show you a different way to get the app as well. But the edu.sphero.com site, once you go through and sign in, will bring you to a page that looks like this. This is your activities page, the homepage on here. And it has a couple different screens you can go through. The homepage is basically is this screen right here. You can scroll through here and it has different activities, different things that are going on, stuff that's put up by Sphero and also stuff that's put through by the community. You also have the activities page, all activities, my activities, so you can create different ones. And the activities are different challenges, if you will. You have a workbook, no activity in the workbook, my activities, I haven't created any or made any activities. The other thing that you have is you have the programs. So you can see all the programs that are out there. Here's different ones. You can also go to My Programs and create your programs. If you go to your profile, obviously you can sign out and everything like that. Drive allows you to drive the robot. Now, we are on the web page here. So if you go to Drive on the website, it's going to say, hey, download one of our programs. And they have the App Store, Google Play, the Amazon App Store. Get it through Microsoft. So if you're on a Windows PC like I am, you can actually download the Sphero EDU app from the Microsoft store, and it opens up into right over here on the side, and it actually looks exactly, if I can click on it, it actually looks exactly like the website. If we go back to the website over here, boop boop, so it looks the same, functions the same, and it's really nice because it's an easy transition over. So you have the web browser, or you also have the program itself, and it looks just a little bit different. Another way you can go through, if you get the Sphero.edu app down here in the bottom, it'll actually bring you to that. Now, my recommendation is to download both to your phone, if you have it on your phone, and also to your PC. So that way you can do the programs either way. And whenever you sign in, those are available across both sides. So if you make a program on the PC, it's in your programs on the app. So whenever you go to the app on your phone, it's already in there, which is nice. You have that compatibility going across. So it's a seamless environment. Now, whenever you download the program, if you're downloading the app either on the Microsoft Store for your PC, or if you're downloading it on the Google Play Store or the App Store, the Apple App Store, you're going to bring it up on your phone. I do recommend, like I said, having it on both devices. This is on my phone. I am running it on the Google Pixel, so I'm an Android user. It does have the device on here, and it's, like I said, linked between my PC and also on my phone, which is really nice. If your computer doesn't have any Bluetooth functionality on your laptop or on your desktop or anything like that, then you'll be able to go through and use your phone to be able to sync to your Sphero Bolt. And those things allow you to do a lot of things, like you do with the drive function and everything like that, whenever you control the any of the Sphero robots through your phone. As long as you have that connection and you're able to make that connection, then you're good to go. For connecting it to your PC, the instruction that I got was to connect the USB charging device for your Sphero Mini or for the Sphero Bolt or your R2-D2 or whatever it is. Connect it to your PC, then go over to Connect Robot. And if it's not, like this one, I have already connected my Sphero Bolt back there to it. But it would go through and it would give you a scan, and you can actually choose a robot to connect to. So I can go through and connect to this one. And because my PC has Bluetooth on it as well, I'm able to actually go through and control my robot and put the programs directly to my robot behind me, which is really nice. If you didn't have that on your PC, the same functionality would work on your phone device, to where you would be able to go through and connect to your Sphero Bolt or your BB-8, whatever it is, your Sphero Mini, and be able to do those functions across. So it is very nice. You're able to do that on there. And through this, you can actually go through and start to create your programs, which will be our next video, and we'll create our first basic program to kind of show some of the functionality that it has on there. So until next time, guys, this is Dreamweaver23 reminding you to robot happy, and I will see you all later. Bye, guys.